Welcome back to Tightwad Workshop. This video is sponsored by Walabot, so today I'll be testing and reviewing their Walabot DIY 2 Visual Stud Finder. The Walabot is a wall stud finder that uses your smartphone as a visual display. The DIY 2 model works with both iOS and Android phones, and it's packaged in a simple cardboard box. The instructions are just this one single-sided page. This label says that you should place this side of the Walabot against your test wall. I'll be using my old Samsung Galaxy A20 Android phone for this test, but the DIY 2 model also works with Apple iPhones. The only other accessory in the box is this power cable, so I'll plug in the Walabot to recharge while I build a test wall. I've drilled a pilot hole here because I'm nailing into a rock-hard piece of 50-year-old Australian hardwood. Now I'll turn the frame over and nail on the top plate. My house uses hardwood diagonal braces, so we'll add one of those too. Now I can stand the frame upright and clamp it to my bench. I'm using softwood for the horizontals so that we can have two different wood densities in the test wall. Next I'll drill some holes for our test pipes and cables. My house uses copper water pipes like this one, but most new houses around here use these PVC plastic pipes instead. I'll also add an electric cable over this side. Now I'll cover it all up with a piece of plasterboard. Next I'll mark the locations of the studs, pipes and wires. Should have measured twice there. I'm marking the internal objects with dotted lines. Now I'll add a power point to the end of the electrical cable. This way the cable will loop down at an angle, just like it does inside a real wall. The water pipes in my house walls are filled with water, so I'll do the same to the test pipes. The old tapper-tapper-tapper stud detection method works okay for finding studs that are touching the plasterboard, but it's not super accurate and it won't detect the pipes or wires that are concealed inside the wall cavity. Now we can go to the Google Play Store and install the Walabot app. Once you've found it, just tap the Install button. Once the app's installed on your phone, you can switch on the Walabot and check that the power indicator lights up. Next we need to pair the two devices. The simplest way is to use the QR code on the Walabot. Now tap the Connect button to continue. The app you installed on your phone contains the most recent updated software that it now needs to download into the Walabot. Just to be clear, the Walabot will only work on walls made from drywall plaster sheets, like our test wall. This is because it uses a radar sensor. It can't see through tiles or concrete. Now we need to calibrate the Walabot to our wall. We do this by tapping the calibrate button, then waving it in wide circles over the wall surface until it tells us to stop. Let's test in the water pipe section of the wall first. It's correctly located the centre of the first wall stud. It's also located the plastic water pipe and the alignment looks good. And here we can see the copper water pipe. At first I thought the Walabot had located the pipe in the wrong place, but then I looked up and I saw that I'd marked my lines incorrectly instead. We've also detected the other vertical stud now. If we zoom in, you can see two dotted lines on the screen that show the exact center line of the stud. If you hold the Walabot upright while you're searching for horizontal studs, you'll get a false reading in image mode. The Walabot, like most other stud finders, needs to be moved from side to side, so you'll need to turn it horizontally to find horizontal studs. Now let's recalibrate the Walabot for the electrical cable side of the wall. Moving down to the power point, we can see that the Walabot has correctly detected the loop in the electrical cable. We've shown image mode so far, but if we touch this button, we'll switch to expert mode. Expert mode shows a heat map of the radar return signal. This slider lets you adjust the sensitivity. That can help you sharpen the image and home in on the edges of objects, which helps to give even more accurate readings. This can also be useful if you're looking for unusual objects hidden in walls. Now let's see if it can find our diagonal brace. It's located the brace correctly, but it's identified it as a pipe or cable. However, if we switch to expert mode, we can locate the first edge of the brace, then the second edge. Now that we've found both edges, we know that this object is too wide to be a wire or a pipe. The Walabot's maximum detection depth is 4 inches or 100 millimetres, and our brace is about 3 inches from the surface of the drywall, so this is very likely why the image mode thought the object was a pipe. But as you've seen, we were able to use expert mode to correctly identify the object. In conclusion, if you need to be able to detect studs, pipes, wires, and mystery objects inside your plasterboard walls, then the Walabot DIY 2 might be just what you need. That's all for now. Thanks for watching. Tightwad Workshop is filmed in front of a live studio audience.